In this lab, we provide three data sheets, one for each time period for you, and this is where you're going to record your data. So here within the data sheets, we have several columns here, one called species name, one called total percent cover, one PI, 1% cover on the panel surface, and one called percent overgrowth. And so the idea here would be, you know, just like lab one with species name, you're just going to define the species however you want. So say there was a red thing I liked, I call that a red thing. There's a yellow thing, I call that a yellow thing. There's a slimy thing, I call that a slimy thing. Doesn't matter what you call it, just as long as you're consistent in the naming. The total percent cover, what does this mean? Is that this is our estimate of number of individuals. So most of these animals are colonial, and so we don't want to count every individual animal. That'll take forever, so we're using percent cover. And so the video in the lab manual discusses how you go about doing that. But here are some sample data. There's a percent cover for the red thing was about 35% of the plate. Yellow thing was 47%. Slimy thing was 20%, and so on. Then the PI value. If you recall the PI value, that's what you're going to use to calculate the diversity index. And that's the proportion of individuals of one species relative to all the different species. And so here I'm going to calculate PI by taking the total percent cover of the red thing, 35%. And divide that by the total percent cover of all the species. Again, that's our estimate of numbers of individuals. In this case, total numbers of individuals. And so if I add the percent cover of the red, the yellow thing, the slimy thing together, I get 102. So the PI for the red thing is 35 divided by 102, or 34%. I just did the same thing for the yellow thing and the same process for the slimy thing. And so these are the percents on the plates for each. Percent cover on the panel surface, this was a little bit different measure. This was what's only physically attached to the panel itself. Contrast that with the total percent cover, which included organisms attached to the panel, plus what's growing on top of other things. Whereas this measurement here, the percent cover on the panel surface, is only about what's physically attached to the panel. And so in some cases, that value might be exactly the same. So for the red thing here, in my example here, all the animal was on the panel and only on the panel, so I got a measure of 35. For the yellow thing, if I compare these values here, I got 47% total coverage, only 45% on the panel, so 2% was on another animal, so I didn't include that. And then same thing for the slimy thing. So I did 20% total percent cover, but 5% was growing on another animal, so I did not include that in this particular column here. Then we're going to use that value to help us figure out percent overgrowth or competition for space. And so what I'm basically going to do is subtract total percent cover and total percent cover on panel surface from each other. And so for the red thing, I get 35 minus 35, which is 0. For the yellow thing, the numbers are a little bit different. You get 47 minus 45, that gives me 2%. And then for the slimy thing, I get 20 minus 15, that's 5%. Then I add those together. That'll give me the total percent cover for the panel at this particular time period.
That's all for this video. Remember, if you have trouble with any of these concepts, please contact your TA. Thank you for watching.